Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today we're going to talk about Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition, and we're going to ask the question, is it ethical for a Dungeon Master to accomplish a goal with their Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition campaign without informing the player characters of the goal the Dungeon Master is attempting to accomplish? All right, that's my question. And give me your answer in the comments below if you have a free moment. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Let me explain my exact situation. So I am currently studying deeply Waterdeep Dragon Heist, and I'm just giving myself as strong and sound an understanding of Waterdeep as possible. And basically what I'm going to do is my intention is to use Waterdeep as a Waterdeep Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition campaign using Waterdeep Dragon Heist to use the political structure of Waterdeep to model the United States of America and specifically skin Andrew Yang as a faction leader that is attempting, and specifically I'm putting it in as an ASMR paladin sage named Yesnar, okay? And his goal is going to be to peacefully remove Lariel Silverhand and place himself in as the open lord of Waterdeep. And the reason why I'm going to do this is I believe if I structure it correctly, what I can do is I can use Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition campaign as a predictive engine to determine what unexpected obstacles Andrew Yang can expect to hit in the 18 months running up to between 18 months as he attempts to become the U.S. presidential candidate. I don't think this has ever been done before. I have a degree in political science, and I also have a master's in technology, specifically technology management. So I'll be using some specifically some Excel pivot tables and kind of things like that as well. But overall, there's going to be a lot of social modeling and political structure modeling to use Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition as a predictive engine to aid a specific U.S. presidential candidate. And my goal is, I was fortunate enough to be able to walk right up to Andrew Yang when he ran in 2020, shake his hand and have plenty of time with him. And he's going to come again in 2024 to Philadelphia, I can guarantee you that. And I want to be ready and tell him, hey, these are the obstacles I think you're going to face as a political candidate that you might not be expecting. And these are my specific advice on how to overcome those, right? So I currently have an amazing team of players. Everybody in my Sunday game is a DM and a player, right? And so basically you get 4 weeks and you can run anything you want, right? And so you get a 2-hour slot for 4 weeks and you can run anything you want. We meet on Sundays. DM A gets to run their game for 2 hours, and then DM B gets to run their game for 2 more hours. It's 4 hours of gaming with 2 2-hour sessions, right? And then the next month, it switches to the other two DM players, and then they run their campaigns, right? So you have a month on and a month off as DM. So I have plenty of opportunities to run this once, twice, or more, right? I may actually model it out in Exandria at a later time, right? But I actually think the predictive engine will work better if the players are unaware of my goal, right? However, I love my players. They're great people. I want to ask first, I want to get some advice. Is it ethical? Is it ethical for a dungeon master to accomplish what they believe to be a benign and or beneficial goal using the charisma, the intelligence, and the confidence of their players as a catalyst, right, to identify for a whole bunch of reasons, right? Like, when you sit players down at the Dungeons & Dragons table, you have an incredible force of charisma, confidence, and intelligence that you can use to accomplish things. many dungeon masters think that their games are, you know, they're just there to have fun, and that's all they're ever going to accomplish, right? But I'm very convinced that Dungeons & Dragons is a powerful force, and it's a powerful tool that can be used to accomplish a whole bunch of things, like an almost an innumerable number of things, right? But I need to check in first. Is this, am I being ethical if I proceed and do this without telling the players, right? Because if it's not ethical, then I'll have to tell them, right? Because I, you know, as dungeon masters, Gary called us to ethics. Wait, did he? Yes. What do you think the alignments were for, right? Like, he told us, you cannot be, like, you can be lawful good, you know, neutral good, chaotic good. You could be lawful neutral, neutral, true neutral, and chaotic neutral. But you cannot be in this life. Gary told us you cannot be in this life chaotic evil, neutral evil, or lawful evil. Heroes don't do that, right? So I heard him. Did you hear him? All right. Like, so I want to do this ethically. I want to do this in the right way, and I want to make this work, right? So what do you think? I think it would definitely benefit me to not tell the players, right? But I'm curious, what do you think? Do you think that's unethical? Because if the majority of the people say, hey, Scott, I think this is unethical, then I'm definitely going to listen, and I don't think I will proceed, and I'll tell my players first, which I think will make the model run a little less efficiently. But I definitely wanted to check in here, because I have a bunch of charismatic, intelligent, confident people I'm fortunate enough to have that are kind enough to comment in my comments. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below. Please consider liking and subscribing, and have a wonderful millennium.